market downfall, that is known as Ponzi prediction. Where the stock market, whether it falls or exists, it does not deal with the recession at all or not interpretable. That is known as numbers. That is the first major thing. And secondly, there are numerical models. They talk about the structure model, integral structure model, innumerable models. That are the famous model given by Dr. Jonathan Hensch, right, the famous economic modelist. He has given a model known as inverted yield curve model. What is the yield curve? Yield curve is the curvature between short and long interest rates. So based on this inversion, we can identify what is the recession at all. The third thing is that global economic indicators level that are being given by the Federal Reserve Bank, FRB, they have given something. One, the slow and slippery of unemployment rate. Number two, the average work rate or work hours. The third thing, the rush for unemployment insurance. Fourth thing, the rate of steady of manufacturing, capital and consumer goods. These things are the diagnostic factors. So before 6 months you can understand. That's why we used to say recession can be smelled before 5 years. Yes. It can be felt before 1 year. It can be touched and experienced within 6 months. Even before 6 months you can do that. But to be totally exhausted or for subjective experience, we can have only after its consequences to realize it too late. But there are smelling factors, feeling factors, touching factors, dealing factors, factors of congenial understanding, proximate understanding of all of these factors are possible. There are innumerable methods given by people. And apart from that, there are also lot of microeconomical factors, individual level factors for that. You see, your quality and behavior of earning, purchasing, investment, saving, asset formation, distribution, work rate, production, work systematism, and always concerned with your international deal and dependence. All of these various things in an individual level, they also form the diagnostic factors, just as you are having skin symptom, tongue symptom, breath symptom, eye symptom, then heartbeat and pulse rate in normal pathology. Your expenditure, investment, saving, distribution, production, marketing, the trend analysis of the structure, and your international or cross national deal and dependence. These things are various factors which you can understand what is happening here. Now, the question is already we have enough recessions. You are also claiming that recession is prognosticable even before a few months or years. Why proper solutions or troubleshooting methodologies have been totally discarded, or what is the reason for the delay in implementation? There may be three reasons. One is ignorance. Second is negligence, third is observance. There cannot be ignorance, as I have already told, that everybody knows this. Second thing is negligence. There cannot be negligence because any ruling party will share the blame or the fate of economic depression or bailout. Whatever that happens, that particular country will be either given blame or fate. So certainly, negligence is also not possible. Subservience is the main reason. Whenever a problem starts in the incubation level, the people either there should be a party of it, there should be a mute spectator of it, or there should be the organizer of it. So without having industrial involvement, recession would not happen. And without having the political involvement, industrial, near industrial boosting, or this fictional market would not have come. So it was told by people that the subservience of people in power, subservience of people in responsibility and response, those who are just meant for asking for it, claiming for it, those who are meant for its restoration or rectification, those who have the governing responsibility and preventive responsibility, those people are indulging in that. So, subservience or mute spectating of the authorities of various cadre that has resulted in all of these problems that has been clearly told by these people. And coming to the real Indian economy status, I have already told in the morning about the country's ability, the masculine economy is to withstand problems, to create, to design and fashion new models, and to interpret it adaptable to all regions and of all levels, and to see that we get the success or solution in the hands we have already told. And I have also hinted about few economic levels. One is trans-economic, the impact of non-economic zones of the society to create economic depression, suppression or economic boost. Second thing is meta-economics, that deals with the behavior of the consumers, producers, and the common behavior or ethical behavior of business professionalism that exists in the society. Number three, I wrote about para-economic status, that is connected with nature, that is unintelligible and not in your hands or God or something else. And considering each and every factor, you should understand the difference between various economic views. Two people are quarreling. Socio-economic view is just to create both of them. and maybe farmers or there is dedication of political parties. I want to clearly say that the political concern for farmers' upliftment is more than the social concern of it. It has been practically viewed also. So this is what I want to say here. And apart from which, I have already told about personal behavior. Personal behavior, it is very much essential. I want to give a small example. Number one, in our general services, indispensable services and social needs, for example, whether you are rich or poor, depression or aggression or anything, you have to get married, you have to construct a house, these are basic social needs in the society. And indispensable needs are medicine and education, and other social services and transportation and other things. So this boost in the economy, it affects the person who are in the lowest standards. That we have to understand that the boost is affecting the lowest standards. For quality education, luxury is not just spending 2 lakhs or 3 lakhs for education. It has become the necessity and organized structure of the society that unless you spend that much of amount, you cannot get into proper education or qualified education. This has created a vacuum in the person's ability and he has to transact in such a way that beyond his ability, possibility and ethical morale, he has to seek some other way to bring these things. So each and everybody's circumstantial pressure and coercion not to be the luxurious life, even to lead a common qualified life, they have to work beyond their ability, they have to earn beyond their capacity and possible means. This each and everybody's capability extension, each and everybody's productivity extension by means of abnormal and subnormal means, that has created a lot of vacuum in the society. We have to understand this. Under this problem is understood, understanding big macroeconomic problems is totally futile. It is a tinsel at all. So this is the basic way of understanding this things. And also, I have already told about imitation behavior. How to imitate other people. Imitation of living of others, imitation of progress model of others, imitation of solution model of others. If these things are not suitable, unless some fundamental grounds, I have clearly told about them at all. And I have also mentioned today about information asymmetry. Very important. I want to say it in a very precise manner. Number one, talking about the problem or naming the problem, giving the positive factors, are giving near solutions. Number four, are naming the solution. Number fifth, giving lot of good explanations for solutions without bringing solution in hand. All of these five things are very much common in society. Even in all other transactions, narrations, and abstracts which are prepared for solution, you can see that. Everybody knows that poverty, what is the medicine for poverty? The person in poverty knows the disease, that is poverty. And what is the solution for that? Money is the solution for poverty, and food is the solution for hunger, and job is the solution for unemployment. Everybody knows that. So, addressing possibilities, addressing names of problems and solutions, and merely addressing things and explanations, those things they won't contribute anything at all. We can hear a lot of things we are studying, just as somebody mentioned, we have to maintain an equal distribution or equal unequal study between inflation and growth. Inflation and growth are like Tom and Jerry. Inflation and growth are like Tom and Jerry. If you boost the growth in high growth, there will be major exports. If there are major exports, then there will be a collapse in your domestic economy. So if there is a